Today, let's talk about the depth of the ocean. 70% of the Earth's surface is covered by the ocean, and 96% of the water on Earth is seawater. This means that our planet is essentially an oceanic planet. However, human knowledge about the ocean is very limited, with estimates suggesting it is less than 5%, similar to our understanding of the universe. Today we will take a look at this mysterious ocean. Did you know that the average depth of the ocean is 3,680 meters? In contrast, the average height of land on Earth is only 860 meters, so compared to land, the ocean is much deeper and wider. The deepest part of the ocean is the Mariana Trench, which is 11,000 meters deep, much deeper than Mount Everest. The distance from the top of Mount Everest to the deepest point of the Mariana Trench is a total of 20,000 meters. Let's dive down now. Firstly, normal swimming depth for humans is not more than 3 meters. Continuing down to 20, 30 meters is the main area for coral reefs and aquatic plant growth. Going down to 40 meters is the maximum depth for recreational scuba diving. If diving beyond 40 meters, people will experience joint pain, dizziness, and vertigo, similar to altitude sickness. Interestingly, people will experience the same symptoms when ascending as when descending, so avoid these areas. The deepest swimming pool in the world is also 40 meters, located in a hotel in Italy called the Monte Grotto Terme. This pool is specifically designed for diving enthusiasts. Continuing the dive to 70 meters, people will experience hallucinations. The world's largest fish, the whale shark, also inhabits this water region. Okay, let's continue diving to 100 meters. This depth is the limit for professional divers. At this depth, there is a giant Pacific octopus, which can change colors like a chameleon and is over 6 meters long. In ancient times, people thought it was a sea monster, and some still do. It's 3 times the size of a human and changes color. Okay, let's go deeper to 130 meters. This is currently the deepest depth for an underwater wedding ceremony in the world. In 2014, 2 professional divers, one from Japan and one from the US, got married at this depth in Thailand. The priest was their coach, who was also a part-time pastor. Not many people can get married at that depth, and the priest is the one who is responsible for the ceremony. Let's dive even deeper to 200 meters. Usually, we call depths beyond 200 meters the deep sea, because there is not enough light for photosynthesis, and green plants are scarce at these depths. However, there is a fish called the oarfish, also known as the sea dragon, which is enormous and could be the real-life inspiration for the legend of sea dragons. It's incredibly long. There's also a challenging extreme sport called free diving, where divers see how deep they can go or how long they can hold their breath. The current world record for the deepest free dive is held by an Austrian named Herbert Nitsch, who went down to 214 meters in 2007. This is usually impossible to achieve because beyond 100 meters, divers start having hallucinations. Going deeper could cause severe problems because of the pressure, like flattening your organs, separating your lungs from your chest, and causing permanent damage. However, Nitsch used the pressure to his advantage by squeezing his abdominal muscles to push his organs up and protect his lungs from collapsing. That's why most people cannot dive that deep. I'm not sure how long he can hold his breath, but the world record for holding your breath in the ocean is 11 minutes. However, the longest recorded breath hold was 22 minutes and 22 seconds, achieved by a Danish man named Stig Severinsen, but he used pure oxygen before holding his breath. Usually, extreme technical divers like them can hold their breath for more than 8 minutes. Keep going to 300 meters, and you'll reach a type of crab that many people often eat. This crab is called Macrochira kempferi, which has extremely long legs and a small head. When its legs are stretched straight, they can be as long as 4 meters. Besides crabs, humans have also been to this place. Earlier, I mentioned that without any equipment, the deepest a human can dive is 214 meters. However, with the help of equipment, such as an oxygen tank, a person can dive up to 332 meters, which was achieved by an Egyptian named Ahmed Gamal Gaber in 2014. He dove to this depth with an oxygen tank on his back in just 15 minutes. Although he intended to dive to 350 meters, He lost his intuition at 332 meters and began to experience various hallucinations. As a result, he had no choice but to start ascending. He spent 15 minutes descending, but 13 and a half hours ascending. The reason for such a slow ascent was due to the various gases, including nitrogen and other gases, in the oxygen tank. Once inhaled, these gases entered his bloodstream and became tiny bubbles that would expand rapidly if he ascended too quickly, causing him to explode or develop oxygen toxicity, resulting in permanent damage to his central nervous system, spinal cord, and eyes. Therefore, he had to ascend slowly, allowing the gases to escape his body gradually. He ascended at a rate of 25 meters per hour, and it took him 13 and a half hours to ascend. During his descent, he was surrounded by 30 personnel, making it relatively safe. To date, no one has broken this world record. In general, submarines operate at depths of around 300 to 500 meters underwater. Okay, let's continue diving down to 500 meters. At this depth, it's no longer a human world. Everything I've talked about so far is related to the human world. We're now entering the animal world. As the largest animal in the world, the blue whale's maximum diving depth is about 500 meters. Not only is it huge in size, but its call is also incredibly loud, reaching 188 decibels, louder than a fighter jet. Furthermore, its call can travel up to 1,600 kilometers, which can attract a pod of whales from that distance with just one call. Besides the blue whale, there's another surprising creature that can survive at this depth. The largest species of penguins, emperor penguins, can easily dive over 500 meters and swim for more than 10 minutes at that depth. They are the most pressure-resistant bird species. This depth is equivalent to the height of Taipei 101. Let's dive further to 600 meters. There is a fish called the barrel-eye fish that has a transparent head. Inside its head, there are two spherical objects, which are its eyes. However, its eyes are upward-facing and can't look forward, indicating that it doesn't need to look down. This type of fish is impossible to catch, and if caught, it explodes. Let's continue to 700 meters. This is where European eels live. They are a popular food, and many people might assume they live in rivers. However, eels spend half their lives in the sea and only go back to rivers to breed. We catch them and eat them. Okay, let's go deeper to 900 meters, where the giant squid lives. The giant squid can grow up to 10 meters long, and its eyes are set deep within its head. Some people might think that the giant squid is rare, but in fact, there should be many of them, and we just don't see them often because we rarely dive to that depth. We will talk about something later that will involve the quantity of giant squid. Continuing on for 1 kilometer, after reaching 1 kilometer, you enter what's called the bathypelagic zone. In this area, there is no light at all, completely dark, and the number of living creatures decreases significantly. At 1,300 meters, there is a type of sea turtle that's the largest of its kind, called the leatherback turtle, and it lives in this area. This type of turtle has a soft shell, and it goes up to the beach to lay its eggs, and then returns to this deep area. Moreover, at this depth, there's also a very scary type of shark called the goblin shark. Due to its appearance being very similar to a goblin, it's also called the goblin shark. Everyone should know what a goblin is, right? Its biggest characteristic is that its mouth and jaw are separated. When it eats, it opens its mouth, and a tooth inside flies out to grab the food, and then it pulls it back in. Just like the alien from the movie, so if you get bitten by it, you wouldn't die from the bite, but rather from the scare. Good. We've reached 1,700 meters. And look, there's a very cute creature here on land, the southern elephant seal. It's the largest species of seal on land, with a particularly big nose. These seals can dive to this depth, and as adults, they can weigh up to 5 tons and grow to almost 7 meters in length. Let's continue diving deeper to 2,000 meters. It's getting scary now. At this depth, we'll find a fish called the black dragonfish. This fish looks like it's from another planet, with its black pointy teeth that resemble the character Venom from a movie. This fish has something on its body that glows, attracting prey in the darkness so it can hunt. Let's keep going further down to 3,000 meters, where we'll enter the deep sea zone. The water temperature here is only between 1 and 2 degrees Celsius, and there is no light. The water pressure exceeds 300 atmospheres, and there are few fish at this depth. But there is a giant whale here, the sperm whale. It's the deepest diving whale and can go down to 3,000 meters to hunt for its favorite food, the giant squid. The giant squid can't dive any deeper than this, so the sperm whale has the advantage. It can hold its breath for over an hour, allowing it to search for the giant squid. The whale can eat up to 5 million giant squid per year, and scientists use the contents of their stomachs to estimate the number of giant squid in the ocean. The sperm whale is called the cachalot, which comes from the French word cachalot, meaning tooth or big teeth. This is because the teeth of the squid it eats are often found in its stomach. Interestingly, the stomach contents of the sperm whale emit a sweet fragrance that was once used to make perfumes and medicine. This is why the sperm whale is sometimes called the perfume whale. Continuing to dive to 3,800 meters, there is a ship at this depth, the Titanic. In 1912, the Titanic and Jack sank to this depth, and even after over 100 years, the ship has not been salvaged. In fact, it has been designated as underwater cultural heritage and is not allowed to be salvaged. If you want to visit it, you won't be able to. However, James Cameron, the director of Titanic, has been there 33 times. Moving forward to 4,000 meters, there are fish living at this depth called viperfish, with very long teeth. Due to the scarcity of food, their teeth are long because they cannot afford to let their prey escape once they catch it. Continuing to dive to 6,000 meters, you enter the ultra-deep sea zone. In 1989, a Japanese submarine called Deep Sea 6,500 inches reached a depth of 6,500 meters. Later, in 2012, China's submersible Xiaolong reached 7,000 meters, and then continued to dive to 8,178 meters, which is the deepest known depth where fish live. In April 2017, a Chinese deep sea exploration team discovered a white fish at a depth of over 8,150 meters. Later in August of the same year, a Japanese team also found the same fish, which may be the same one. Several of these fish were found, and the Japanese team fed them shrimp, causing them to come closer to eat. This fish still does not have an official name, but is currently called the Mariana snail fish. It is not yet known whether this fish can swim deeper, or if there are other fish living at greater depths. Continuing to dive to 10,660 meters, we discovered a huge single-celled organism, a primitive protist, that although a single cell was 20 centimeters long, that's one cell, 20 centimeters. This is an extremely primitive species, so it's possible that billions of years ago, single-celled organisms were this big. Now let's take a look at the deepest part of the ocean, the Mariana Trench, which has a depth of 11,034 meters at its lowest point, the Challenger Deep. This area was first measured in the 1950s, but at that time, the maximum depth that could be measured was only about 1,000 to 2,000 meters. To measure this depth, bombs were dropped into the trench to create a sound wave, and the depth was determined by analyzing the sound wave. So far, only four people have reached this depth. Two people, Don Walsh and Jacques Picard, reached the depth in 1960 and spent 5 hours there, but had to quickly return to the surface due to a cracked window. They observed some flatfish and shrimp before ascending. In 2012, James Cameron, with the support of National Geographic and Rolex, descended to the Challenger Deep and spent over 2 hours at the bottom, where he saw shrimp-like creatures that were 3 centimeters long, but not much else. He described the ocean floor as barren, like the surface of the moon. The last person to reach this depth was Victor Vescovo, a private equity investor and ocean explorer who made two dives in April and May 2019. He reached a depth of 10,928 meters and reported seeing only plastic bags on the ocean floor. It's disappointing to see that compared to 1960, when there were flatfish and shrimp, and even 2012, when there were still shrimp-like creatures, now there is only garbage. Further exploration of the ocean depths can help us understand the limits of biological survival and aid in our understanding of the universe, as the current understanding is that some living organisms can survive without light. So, it's not necessary to look for life only around stars, but water is a must. 94% of the organisms on this planet are aquatic. Terrestrial organisms like us are very rare. Even as land-dwelling creatures, we still need water to survive. Currently, it is known that no living organism can survive without water. However, there are some microorganisms that can enter a state of suspended animation when there is no water. They show no signs of metabolism or activity, but if you give them a drop of water, they immediately come back to life. Maybe that's why when you look at the moon, it appears to be barren and made up of rocks. But if you were to give it a bottle of water, even those rocks could come back to life. It's entirely possible.